Hi, today we present our F500 supercritical CO2 extraction machine. This machine is we use normally CO2 as a supercritical fluid as a solvent, but today we will use a different fluid which name is R134. It's a cooling lamp actually. Now we will work on a lavender leaves. Here we have dried lavender leaves. I am putting it an extraction vessel with a fabric basket. Here we have two separators. First one to take the extract. Here Falcon tube that we weighed earlier. Here. And the second one is used as a trap, liquid trap. We poured in it pure water to trap some oils, aromatic oils. And now, lighting the apertures here. Ready, and the other one. That's enough. Now I am closing the cover. The apertures. Now it's ready. I will pull the restriction valve. Yeah, it's closed also. And now open the valve here and tube. I'm using this tube in this position because to take R134 gas in liquid phase. I open valve fully. It's ready. The pressure is here 3.5 bar. The extraction vessel is preheated to 60 centigrade of Celsius. The restriction temperature and the separation temperature is here. You see. We applied some updates on the program software from graph to see pressure and temperature. Now we can start the process. Pressurize the R134 to the 200 bar pressure, and this is the 60 Celsius of temperature. I can start the pump here now. Then when it comes to the set pressure, then I will start the fluid flow. It's started. Here the pressure is increasing rapidly because of the liquid phase. We are now using R134A gas in subcritical state because it's the critical state. Temperature is 100 centigrade of Celsius. So we are applying subcritical but high pressure extraction. Now, here the graph. Pressure increasing rapidly now to the because of the liquid phase. But in first minutes, here in this graph. In first minutes, the liquid is filled in the vessel, then the pressure increases. This is a 200 bar pressure. We can apply more. We can set the pressure 300 bar. Remaining time start decreasing because of set value is reached. The set value was 200 bar. Now the pressure is 300. Here we can wait some time for static extraction, or we can directly start dynamic extraction and flow of carbon R134A gas. Now we have waited 10 minutes for static extraction. Now we can start the dynamic extraction. I'm opening the restriction valve. When I open the restriction, the pressure of the system is decreased and pump remain set points of pressure. Here, gas comes first stage separator. It's a Falcon tube. Then extract, drop. Bottom of the Falcon tube, the gas goes on here, the liquid trap, then to the flow meter to see the flow, then to the atmosphere. Now the process is done. Yeah, we stop the pump of the system, then so pressure start to decrease. Open the restriction valve. I am closing the R134 bottle valve. I'm closing. Here we have take this amount of extracts. When we compare to supercritical CO2 extraction, this is less than the CO2 yield, because it's it should be 5 or 6 milliliter level in CO2, but in the R134 yield is hit. But maybe the ingredients of the extracts is different than the supercritical CO2. We are finishing the process by decreasing the pressure. You can see the droplets of the extracts coming from the restriction valve. The separation tube. I will show the extracts. Extract is here the extract. There are some wax content is high, it seems, because viscosity is like honey. So viscous, like honey. Extract is so viscous. Probably has a high amount of waxes